Okay, hi friends, this is the key of industrial engineering test 1, which one already I uploaded. So we'll see the first question. The first question answer is C, that is Dilpi technique. So Dilpi technique. And second question answer is long range forecasting. That answer is D, that is correlation and regression. Okay, so you see this one D. And for a third question, which one of the following forecasting technique is most suitable for making a long range forecasting? For long range forecasting, that is the D, that is the market survey. Okay, next fourth question, if you see, they are asking for the February month, what is the expected forecasting? So that problem will solve like this method, f of t is equal to f of t minus 1 plus alpha into e. So here e is the difference between the previous one minus the recent one. So 450 minus 500, so that is minus 50 we will get. And if you substitute in that formula, alpha is equal to already given 0.10, so if you get the 495, that is the D is the correct answer. Fifth one is A, that is regression analysis. Sixth one is D, that is direct survey method. And seventh one is A, that is mean absolute deviation, that is measurement of a forecast error. And eighth one is, we solved here, absolute deviation means the mod of the E1, E2, E3 and E4. E1, E2, E3, 4 are the difference between those forecastings. Okay, so these are those forecastings. So mean absolute deviation means mod. Mod means the negative terms also will become positive. That's why this minus 100 is become here plus 100. So you get this all value. If you do it, that you get 170. So next, bias asking. Bias asking means it is not included mod. So here just we have to whatever value we get, that one by n. N means number of forecasting. So that is 4. We get the bias is 120. Okay. Next, they are asking here in this question, 11th, 10th question, 9th question. 9th question is how much we got? That is n periods. 9th one is C, that is n minus 1 periods. Okay. So we'll see n minus 1 periods. 10th one is A, that is forecast overheads. So prime cost plus forecast overheads. Next, 11th is they are asking break even point sales, they are asking, that is the fixed cost by selling price minus variable price. So you substitute that all, you get 500 is the correct answer. So remember the formula. Next, 12th one is B means that is optimum lot size. EOQ is optimum lot size. Next, 13 question, that is the formula. EOQ is equal to 2AP by I. A is the demand, P is the ordering cost, I is the holding cost. Okay, that is the formula for EOQ. Remember that formula, very important. Next, 14 is B, that is equal to the cost of ordering. At EOQ, cost of carrying is equal to cost of ordering. So, P equal to I. Okay, 15th is A. So, that is, if you see the 15th question, that is A means no safety stock. So for ABC analysis, inventory forecasting, for A type of forecasting, there is no need of safety stock. Next, 16 is A, that is in ABC analysis, A is required how much percentage of items? 10 to 20%. So that is 10 to 20%. Next, EOQ again question on this one they are asking, but here they are, so actually demand is calculated for 12 months. So 60 they gave per month, so that's why I multiplied with 12. And next here 12 is ordering cost they gave, and 100 into 12. Okay, so that is the for 60 months we calculated, so 12 months we calculate, that's why here 16 into 12. And here the holding cost also always per year we will calculate, that's why into 12. That's, you got the answer. Now here in the 19th question they are asking the break even point can be lowered by, means decreased by, how can we can decrease? So this is the break even point formula. In this one, if you increase the variable cost, decrease the variable cost, what will happen? This numerator, the denominator will become increase, because the negative value decrease means the whole value will become increase. When denominator value is increase, the whole value will decrease, because whenever denominator is increase, the whole value will become decrease. So that's when you know. So that is the, by lowering the variable cost, that is the D is the correct answer. Next, 20 is B, that is the disposing of inventory. So purification of inventory means disposing of inventory. Next, 21 is B, that is the reliable control of inefficiency. So large scale inventory, if you keep, then that is, there is no we are not doing any proper efficiency, we not get the proper efficiency, large size of inventory. So that much now keeping is not good, because holding cost will increase. Next, 22. So in 22, you will see they are asking EOQ. So EOQ, the ratio they are asking, EOQ means ordering side is equal to holding cost. So then that ratio will become, both will equal, then it will become 1. Okay, 22 is D. 23 is D, that is solving a system of linear equation. You know, simplex method means solving a system of linear equation. 24th is C. So dummy basic variables, which is, so there is no physical meaning, means that is as a artificial variable, so there is no value for that. So that is the C is the correct answer. Next, 25 is D. So that is the unbound solution. So negative, whenever the this ratio will become negative, then that we call as a, what we called, unbound solution. So if you see the question, you will get that idea. So 26 question, how many number of lines will be there? So this is the m+2. So that is the C is the correct answer. Next, 27, you see, the match the following. So 27 is B. So 27 is B. So here if you see John Newton, so that you get, so this is the B is the correct answer. Okay, next, 28 is D. So a type for the leaving the variable in a simplex procedure is we called as a degeneracy. Okay, this is D. Next, 29th is C, non-degenerative basic variable solution. And 30 is, whenever there is a mixed constraints will be there, then that problem we can solve by the Big M method, that is the E. So with this the test one on industrial management, that is industrial engineering, IMOR, is finished. It is very important subject for competitive exams. Okay, so remaining 3 tests also I will upload, and I will upload all RS Kurmi and RKGN questions also, I will upload in 4 parts. Okay, all the best. So please subscribe.